Hey investors, thanks for investing your time in this video. I hope you all get a great return. Okay, you are provided with the materials shown in the picture, a candle, some tacks, and a book of matches. Your job is to attach the candle to the wall and light the candle in such a way so the candle wax won't drip onto the table below. You have got 15 seconds. If you want, then you can pause the video, because on average, it takes around 5 minutes to solve this problem. So let's go. How long did it take? And here's the solution. Here's an interesting fact about this experiment candle problem. Children are better and faster than adults in solving this problem. Surprising, right? We always assume as you grow older, we get better at problem solving. To some extent, that's what our school grades made us believe. The reason why adults are worse than children in solving this problem is because of cognitive bias called functional fixedness. Functional fixedness is when an adult is slowed down in coming to a solution because of their knowledge of an object's conventional function. We develop intuitions about function from our past experience of problem solving, and we just fail to see alternate function. You look at the box and see only one function as a container for the tacks. Take this test. Can you please read what's inside all three boxes? Let's talk about first and third boxes. I guess you read the first box as ABC and the third one as 12, 13 and 14. Did you realize the middle item on both boxes is the same? But why did you read the same item as B in the first box and as 13 in the third box? One of the reasons is the priming effect. Here's another example of priming effect. Fill in the blank. If you have recently seen or heard the word eat, you're more likely to complete the word fragment, S-O-P, as a soup rather than as soap. The opposite would happen if you had just seen was, and it's because of the priming effect. Here the idea of eat primes the idea of soup, and was primes soap. So the priming is a phenomenon whereby exposure to one stimulus influences how people respond to a subsequent stimulus without conscious guidance or intention. Similarly, when you read Anne approached the bank, what did you visualize in your mind? Anne approaching the bank to withdraw or deposit cash? But for some of you, if you live nearby a river or if you happen to river recently, you might have imagined Anne approaching the river bank. But for most of us who have been to the bank, the financial institution, more often than a river bank. Most of the time, repetitive stuff or things we are more exposed to is on top of our mind. And you know how propaganda works. The most two effective techniques to spread propaganda are: the more same message is repeated, there's a better chance it will stick in your mind. And over time, even the repetition of obvious lies will sound like the truth. And more friends and families or more news sources feed you the same lie, more effective is the propaganda. Frequency and density. You always read ABC and 12, 13, 14 and almost never A13C or 12B14. Your experience told you subconsciously what the second item in each box should be. Similarly, your past experience of problem solving shaped your brain on the function of each item. As you grow older, our brains are hardwired to respond in a specific manner for a specific stimulus. While learning new skills, our brain changes in two ways: chemical changes in the brain, which is about short-term memory; structural changes of the brain, which is about forming long-term memory. Here I want to talk only the second type of change, which is the result of our experience. I'm not a neurologist, so from what I understand, this is how our brain changes when we learn new skills. Imagine a sky full of stars. Let's call each star a neuron. Neurons are nerve cells in our brain. So when you are learning new skill, imagine these stars getting connected to each other through a pipe. A single star can connect to thousands of other stars. After some trial and error, your brain finds the most efficient path between neurons, and as you keep practicing the same skills for a long time, the connection gets thicker and stronger. This thickening of connection or a pipe means chemical signal transfers more easily between neurons. And once the path is determined, our brain fires an electric signal in a very specific and fixed pattern. This firing in the fixed pattern also means our way of thinking about the world becomes very rigid and mechanical, and hence functional fixedness. Remember how people tackle problems? They say like, in the past, we tackled similar problems in such and such way, so maybe we should deal with it in a similar way. If a problem arises, then follow this set of instructions. Just like I used to code commands into a computer program, if the input is 0, turn the robot left, and if 1, turn right. The older you get, the more problems you'll face and more if then solution you'll learn from these problems. Experienced people will be quicker in coming up with a solution to a familiar problem. But as soon as the problem is new, just like the COVID-19 pandemic, everyone will be in a bit of shock and confusion. No one knows how to deal with it. Abraham Maslow said, I suppose it's tempting if only tool you have is hammer to treat everything as if it were a nail. That's why many experienced people shut down innovative ideas because by definition, innovation is new and unique. And new and unique is incompatible with the traditional if-then system our brain is hardwired to. Our experienced or hardwired brain or system will just pop up the message, incompatible idea. So when you come up with an innovative solution, don't go to experienced people. Usually they will reject your innovative solution because it won't fit in their if-then thinking. Also remember, all advice is autobiographical, and we talked about it in the previous video, and if you are curious, the link is up here. I thought about talking how experience shapes our brain and why experts are worse at forecasting in this video, but it was too long, so I had to break it down into two videos. If this interests you, please subscribe and don't miss out. So that's it for today. Thanks for your time and see you in the next one.